Welcome to RMCA Bishop channel. I hope, my dear friend, you are keeping fine. It is great that you could find some time to listen to God's message for you. You know, Pope Francis in his message for the World Day of the Sick 2021 says, sickness always has more than one face. It has the face of all the sick. But also, he says, those who feel ignored, excluded, and victims to social injustices that deny their fundamental rights, these people also come in the category of people who are sick. So, just considering people who are sick physically or mentally sick alone is not enough. We also should side by side consider the people who suffer in this manner. And he has explained this in the encyclical Fratelli Tutti in number 22. The current pandemic has highlighted the inequalities in our healthcare systems and exposed inefficiencies in the care of the sick. You know, we were getting all kinds of news from the media. Elderly, weak, and vulnerable people were not always granted access to care. It seems in some countries, ventilators were not given for the elderly and the weak. They were left to die in front of the eyes of their own family members. What a painful situation it was. It was terrible. We must understand that this is the result of political decisions. The leaders for whom people voted became the masterminds of killing of their own people. Okay, they might say that we did not have sufficient number of ventilators, but who are they to judge whom to keep alive and whom to leave to die? People highly speak of resource management, not giving ventilators or healthcare to the old and the weak was seen by these people as management, resource management. When the resources are meager, you have to select people. But it is not morally right to select people to live and others to die. We cannot accept it. My dear, management without a real love is simply the cruel principle of might is right. This is a glaring example of greater or lesser commitment on the part of those holding positions of responsibility. This should change. We all know that investing resources in the care and assistance of the sick is a priority linked to the fundamental principle that health is a primary common good. Therefore, one thing Pope Francis acknowledged in his message and praised during the pandemic situation is the dedication and generosity of healthcare personnel, volunteers, support staff, priests, men and women religious, all of whom have helped, treated, comforted, and served so many of the sick and their families with the professionalism, self-giving, responsibility, and love of neighbor. Pope Francis says, a silent multitude of men and women, they chose not to look the other way, but to share the suffering of patients whom they saw as neighbors and members of our one human family. When I say this, I remember, unfortunately, once in the southern state of Kerala in India, a gentleman returned from abroad when COVID-19 was spreading in that country. The non-availability of the ventilator was one of the reasons for him to return home. There was a fear in that country that they may not give ventilators to foreign people, for outsiders. This could be just one of the many rumors. Anyhow, out of fear, he returned home. But his wife refused to open the door for fear of COVID-19. Though the husband assured her that he was not positive, but she did not open the door. In the end, police came, and yet she did not open the door for her husband. I think later he had to go to his parents' house. We can imagine the impact of such a treatment from one's own wife on him. It was unfortunate because it was in some sense a violation of the marital commitment made before God, no? Saying, in health and sickness we shall be together. It is in this context the efforts of health volunteers are praiseworthy. You know, in Italy it is said that the Capuchin fathers are revered, respected and loved even now more than any other religious congregation. The reason is, they say, once when there was a plague in that country and families were refusing to look after their family members, even to feed them, the Capuchins went from house to house, feeding them, giving them bath and changing their dress, etc. The people even now speak about such kindness, for which the Capuchin fathers are loved by everyone everywhere in Italy. You know, Saint Francis of Assisi is also the patron of Italy. We must be people with the kindness. We must be kind to people who suffer. We must be careful about people who fake themselves to be victims of sickness, natural calamity, injustice, etc. That we should not. Unfortunately, these days sometimes even media support such people. I am talking about people who really suffer. Let us start with our own parents who could be old and sick. Take care of them. No matter what kind of pranks they throw around, they may even speak silly things, nonsense, but ignore that because they are suffering. Take care of them. Similarly, let us also visit our relatives who are old and sick. Let us also visit our neighbors who are old and sick. Thus, let us be kind to all those who suffer. And then what will happen? God will be kind to us always. Now, I'm going to pray for you, my dear subscriber. I praise and thank you, Lord, for having chosen your beloved child today to listen to your message. You inspired this your child to give some priority to spiritual talks of RMCA in daily life. Abba, Father, without you, we are nothing. Without you, nothing has any value. I thank you for the blessings you have showed on this child as your child listened to your message that came through this video. Oh Jesus, grant your powerful protection from all kinds of sicknesses, accidents, dangers, and other problems and difficulties. Throw into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl around the world seeking the ruin of souls. Oh Holy Spirit, rebuild in your child the virtue of showing kindness to those who suffer. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God bless you and your family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If possible, please listen to two videos of your choice once again. If you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please feel free to do so. All the best. Once again, God bless you. Please keep me too in your prayers. Always, your humble servant, Bishop Frank Komolakia.